introduction. Respected guests, trustees of Eisenhower Fellowships, my dear fellows, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I am both honored and humbled to be standing here this evening to represent the Multi-Nation Program Class of 2015. On behalf of our class, let me first express our deepest gratitude to the trustees and management team of Eisenhower Fellowships for giving us the opportunity to experience this transformative, profound, and very well-designed program. Thank you very much. A round of applause for the trustees. As you saw in the video, the MNP class of 2015 is diverse in its truest sense. Among us, we have captains of industry, the drivers of the economy, we have leaders from the civil society and the public sector, we have educators who are influencing the next generation. And after General Powell's encouragement earlier today, hopefully the next president of Nigeria too. Although there is a multitude of nationalities, cultures, and professional interests among all of us in the MNP 2015, we all embarked on this journey to discover and learn how we can positively impact the world around us. Our journeys over the past 7 weeks have taken us across the length and breadth of America, from big cities to small towns, from Fortune 500 companies to national landmarks. For me personally, the experience has been very rewarding. Through my 75 plus meetings across 10 cities, I have learned how to leverage technology to scale up our work in Bangladesh. I have learned best practices in nonprofit management and succession planning. The journey for me also has been quite reflective. And many of the conversations that I've had during the fellowship helped me take an inward look at my life. And I remember one particular conversation I had with Dan Mazina, who recently retired as the US ambassador to Bangladesh. Dan and his wife Grace are good friends from home, and they invited me for dinner at their place in DC when I was in DC. And during our dinner, Dan said to me, "Ejaj, you've become an Eisenhower Fellow, you've built a successful institution in Bangladesh, you're going up in life. How will you make sure that you're grounded? How will you make sure that you stay connected to your purpose and not get derailed, which many leaders do?" And that made me reflect on my own journey and made me realize the challenges that I've had to have a perspective on my own purpose in life. After finishing my American education, I moved back in 2008 and moved in with my parents with a dream of launching my own nonprofit. My friends thought I had gone crazy, my parents were disappointed in me, and there was a time when I was also disappointed in myself. But one day, when I was coming home, I met this little girl, 10 years old. She was wearing a red frock, faded and torn in places, and she came up to me and she said, "Sir, will you buy this flower for me?" I was single at the time, so I said to her, "No, who would I buy this for?" And as I was walking home, entering my house, it occurred to me, why do I always go home and log into my Facebook account and I look at my friends who are traveling around the world, pursuing amazing careers at McKinsey and BCG, and I always complain, why is my life not like that? Why do I never look down at that poor girl and say how privileged I am? And that is the struggle of my life. How much do I look up and take from the world? How much do I look down and give back? General Power, when you spoke earlier today, you spoke about purpose and what is your true north in life. And I think the essence of what you said is the purpose in our lives cannot be just survival. Because if you and I only strive to survive, then all of us in this room would fail in that test. So the purpose of life has to be to thrive. To thrive means to grow in new ways, to connect to something that is larger than yourselves, because it is only by adding value to the lives of others that we can make our lives count. And as the ship of my life sails from the promised land of America to the beautiful shores of Bangladesh, I take the Eisenhower key with me. And this key was given to each one of us during our orientation week. When I go back to Bangladesh, I will hang this key in my office. Because this key to me represents the trust that you have had on all of us, the fellows. And for me, this represents the friendships that I've forged along the journey. This key to me is also a reminder of our purpose. Of our purpose to open door for others. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ejaj Ahmad.